Sharon, welcome to the show. Great to see you.
You guys.
I have to just say a little background here. Not only are you a mom of two, you worked for the Space Shuttle program for 22 years, an Air Force veteran, which is basically where you began your aerospace career and passion. By the way, thank you for your service. And this is such, you have such an incredible story. Let's talk about that aerospace passion. Where did it begin for you?
My career actually chose me. When I joined the Air Force, you know, before you join, you have to take a test. And they go by your test scores and the different areas of the test and decide where you will work. The first job they offered was air traffic controller, but I hadn't graduated high school yet. So the next job that came up that matched my test scores was aerospace physiology.
Wow, and it's so incredible. Courtney, I second you. Reading through all of the things that you've accomplished, it's pretty staggering. Let's go back to 1992, specifically, you know, this mission flown by the Space Shuttle Endeavour. So Dr. Jemison, you were her suit tech, and
correct.
This job is so critical because you are responsible for processing essentially the orange launch and re-entry pressure suit assemblies worn by the astronauts down to every single detail. Like escape equipment, riding utensils, the diaper. Describe to us just how detailed this job was, because I can imagine the pressure. You don't want to miss a single thing.
Exactly. And as I was mentioning in another interview, the suits, that one astronaut, that's not just their suit. Other people wear that suit as well. Mm-hmm. So you have to continually prep it. You have to take the neck ring apart. You have to take different seals and things apart. And continue to keep it processed. And also, after so many times, you know, it might get too damaged, it'll become a training suit, so it'll never go to space again. But yeah, I tell people when I would train them, treat it like your child is going to be wearing that suit. And make sure you tighten every screw, lube every seal, do everything you're supposed to do. Because if your child was in it, you would want it to be perfect.
You know, I know this was your passion. I know this was your job. But in the moment, or maybe just stepping out from that life, when you look back in that moment, did you realize how big this was for you?
No, I did not, because like you said, you know, you get bored because you do the same thing every day. You know, I'm suiting up astronauts, and of course Mae was not the only astronaut I suited up. I suited up many astronauts over my career, even when I was suiting up Mae, I didn't realize how big it was, you know, because I had done it so long in the Air Force prior to coming to Houston. So it hit me, it really didn't hit me how big until 2017 when Hidden Figures came out.
Mm-hmm.
And people were saying, you should tell your story. And I assumed everybody knew because I was in photos with her, but right. I was hidden in plain sight. It's like they didn't even see me, you know? So I just assumed everybody knew. And so when I reached out and told my story, then it started spreading. And people are like, what you did? Even people in my own hometown, I'm from Moss Point, Mississippi. They didn't even know that I had done that. Even though I was in all these photographs with her, right. Even the little video clip, as you saw, people just didn't know. And that's, yeah, that's Colonel Fred Gregory right there. Yep.
Hidden in plain
amazing.
Sight.
And then, and you know, I made my own history, of course, because I was the only Black woman in my department. Mm-hmm. And I worked from the very bottom as a C technician all the way up to manager before I departed.
And alongside all of those firsts, and it's so much fun seeing these photographs of you, it was no big deal for you to just travel to Kennedy Space Center often, working to support multiple shuttle launches, not just the Endeavour. When your space career ended, when the shuttle program came to an end in 2011, that must have been... that must have been kind of a frustrating time, right? Because I know for a lot of us who grew up, I mean, the space shuttle program was everything. To see it come to an end, describe to us how you felt at that time.
Yeah, the space shuttle program was definitely a huge source of pride for all of us in the space city, of course, and down in Florida. But we knew ahead of time, so it wasn't like they just told us a week before that it's going to end. President Bush had already made plans that it was going to be retirement. So we were well aware of it. But it did hurt a lot of people, you know, hurt our hearts and, you know, the great jobs, because I loved, absolutely loved my job. And there's very few people that can say they actually love their job like I did.
Right.
And I stayed there until the end, so we have to pack up everything and send it back to NASA. So it really did hurt, and not only economically, but like I said, a lot of us, that's all I've done my whole life. Right out of high school, pressure suits in the Air Force. Come to Houston, right after I got the Air Force, pressure suits, my whole life. That's what I've done.
Well,
so
here's your...
It hurt.
here's your chance, Sharon. Speak to young girls out there, women, young girls of color, and a way to just go after your dream, and that women can do it just as good, if not better, than men.
Exactly, exactly. And I was one of the best in my career field, and it can be done. Anybody's trainable. And that's one thing I preach. You know, you don't have to have, where are you gonna get press suit experience except working on them? So you have to give people a chance and let them have that opportunity to learn how to do the job. There are so many other career fields in the space program besides becoming an astronaut. So kids, do not give up. And I did not have a college degree. I accomplished all of this without a college degree. So it's possible. You know, don't feel down on yourself because you may not be able to afford to go to school. You can still make it. The military is a great choice. It's the best choice I could have made to kick my career off. But you can still be a huge success. I'm living proof.
Sharon McDougle, you are living proof of success indeed. What an inspiration. Thank you so much for your time today.
Thank you for having me.
Very impressive career to be proud of, for sure. And to connect with Sharon, you can visit our website, HoustonLife.tv.
And now we're going to check in with Joe Sam, who's trying